Let us pray. In Christ, all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell, and through him God was pleased to reconcile to himself all things. Please stand for our opening hymn. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Please be seated. Good morning and a very warm welcome to St. Margaret's, especially if you're joining us for the first time. We're entered into ordinary time, that little time before Epiphany and the celebrations of Christmas and the first revelation of God and Lent and the long journey to the cross. And today we're focusing on baptism and the Trinity as a way to bring our service together. But we rejoice today with Jack and Evie as they thank God for the gift of life and bring Jeremy for baptism. God raised Jesus Christ from the dead and sent the Holy Spirit to recall the whole world to himself. In baptism, we die to sin and rise to newness of life in Christ. Here we find rebirth in the Spirit and set our minds on his heavenly gifts. As children of God, we are continually created anew as we walk the path of faith and feed on the forgiveness of his healing grace. Please stand for the Gloria.
Thank you.
Almighty God, you have created the heavens and the earth and made us in your own image. Teach us to discern your hand in all your works and your likeness in all your children. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit reigns supreme over all things, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. And would the children like to follow Caitlin out of the side into the parish center for Sunday school?
A reading from the letter to the Colossians. Christ is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in him all things in heaven and on earth were created, things visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or rulers or powers, all things have been created through him and for him. He himself is before all things, and in him all things hold together. He is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, so that he might come to have first place in everything. For in him all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell, and through him God was pleased to reconcile to himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, by making peace through the blood of his cross. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
May I speak in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated. Well, we've just heard a reading, our gospel reading was from the book of John. Did you know that in the book of John, he refers to Jesus 15 times with different names? So here we have heard him be called the Word. He's also called in John's Gospel the Door, the Messiah, the Bread of Life. So our names are important. So I want you to just spend a few moments thinking about your name. Think about why you have your name, who chose it. Our names are more than combinations of letters. They carry meanings, stories, and legacies. In many cultures, names are carefully chosen to reflect values and hopes and dreams. They bind us to our families, our communities, and heritage. Our names are an integral part of our identity, shaping who we are and how we perceive ourselves in the world. So our names have been carefully chosen for us, whether we are named after family members, people our parents admire, names that they have just always liked, or by scanning the baby name book to find something a bit different. So in choosing our names, there would have been discussion. There would have been names you absolutely didn't want. My husband wanted our daughter Meg to be called Iris, after the novelist and philosopher Iris Murdoch. But for me, the name reminded me of a woman who I knew as a child called Iris, who was very nice, but chain-smoked and has a nicotine moustache. It was not going to be Iris. And there is sometimes disagreement between parents when choosing a name. Sometimes the names just come out of the blue. My nephew is called Jupiter because when discussing what to call him, they happened to be listening to Holst's The Planets and not coming to an agreement, Jupiter it was. Well, some parents know before conception the names they will give their children, and some can't decide on a name until the baby is born. Today is a really special day because we have a very, very special guest. Jeremy Ronan Stewart has come to be baptized with his parents, Jack and Evie. So what about his name, Jeremy Ronan? Well, Jeremy is an English name derived from the biblical name Jeremiah, meaning appointed by God. That is a strong name. Now, Jack and Evie told me that they wanted a biblical name, but one that didn't sound too harsh, when you said it. And I think you'll agree that Jeremy has a musical sound to it as it rolls off the tongue. And what of Jeremy's second name, Ronan? Could it be that Jack and Evie have a love of Ronan Keating and are massive Boyzone fans? Perhaps. But the name Ronan is much more profound than that. So Ronan is an Irish name that means little seal. And Jack and Evie gave their baby Ronan as a second name because he was born inside the unruptured amniotic sac. And he looked like a little seal. It is very rare for a baby to be born in this way. So, Jeremy Ronan, you are very unique indeed. So the history of names is so ancient that no one really knows the beginning of the story. But since written history began, and as far back as oral history reaches, people have had names. It is therefore impossible to do more than guess at how the earliest names were chosen. But most names appear to have had some sort of original meaning, usually descriptive, rather than just being simply a pleasing collection of sounds. And the biblical concept of naming was rooted in the ancient world's understanding that a name expressed essence. A name had meaning. To know the name of a person was to know that person's character and nature. In biblical tradition, it usually fell to the mother to name the child, on occasion the father. And we know that there are occasions when God directly named the child. For example, Abraham and Sarah were told that they would bear a son and his name would be Isaac. And an angel appeared to Zechariah and told him that his wife Elizabeth would also have a son and that they should call him John, who became known as John the Baptist. And we also see in the Bible times when God changed people's names. Jacob, who was visited by an angel who said he would now be known as Israel. When Jesus met Saul, he changed his name to Paul. And also Simon, he called Peter. All of those names had meaning. Our names are important, and there is much said about your name in Scripture. God has deep knowledge of us. The scriptures repeatedly affirm that God knows us intimately, far beyond our understanding. In Isaiah, the Lord declares, "I have called you by name. You are mine." It's powerful, isn't it? Well, this profound statement encapsulates the depth of God's knowledge and love for each of us. God knows us, and it wasn't a chance encounter. Jeremiah says, before we were even formed in the womb, God knew us. And in Matthew, we are told that even the hairs of your head are all numbered. Jesus uses a vivid metaphor to convey God's intimate knowledge and care for us, his people. The fact that even the smallest details, such as the number of hairs on one's head, are known to God, just demonstrates his extraordinary attention and concern for us. And the idea that God knows us by name goes beyond mere recognition. It speaks deeply to a personal relationship with him. Our names are etched in the palm of God's hand, says Isaiah, a constant reminder of our worth and significance in his eyes. In a world that often defines us just by our achievements or our possessions or our appearances, we have to know that our true identity is found in God's love and acceptance. Remember, God created all of us in his image, the Imago Dei. When we embrace our identity in God, we find purpose, security, and belonging because he knows our name. Knowing that God knows us by name calls us to live in response to his love and grace. If he has called me by name, then he has called you by name. And I don't know about you, but this compels me to try to treat others with dignity, even when they irritate me or they annoy me. It is a challenge when we're in disagreement or we feel challenged by another person to recognize the divine imprint in each other. We encounter because God knows them by name. They are made in the image of God. It challenges us to live authentically, embracing our true selves without fear or shame, because God knows us personally. As we journey through life, let us always remember that we are known and loved by God. This morning, we are going to make promises. As a congregation, we will promise to welcome Jeremy into the Church of Christ, to uphold him in Christ. Parents and godparents, you will promise to pray for Jeremy throughout his life, to lead by example and walk with him in the way of Christ, to take care of him as he grows up and takes his place within the life and worship of God's church, so that he grows up in the knowledge that he is a beloved child of God, that through his life he will know that God knows him intimately because God knows his name. So as we reflect on the significance of our names and God's intimate knowledge of each of us, may we find comfort and strength and hope in the assurance of his love. Let us carry this truth in our hearts as we navigate the complexities of life, knowing that we are never alone, for we are known by name in the presence of the one who created us and calls us his own. Amen.
Can I now invite Jeremy and his parents and godparents to come to the font? My name, of course, means stupid or clumsy. I don't think there are any Brutuses in my family either. Do some of you want to come to the side? Lovely, thank you. How are you doing? You all right? Yeah. Faith is the gift of God to his people. In baptism, the Lord is adding to our number those whom he is calling, people of God. Will you welcome Jeremy and uphold him in his new life in Christ?
With the help of God, we will.
Parents and godparents, the church receives Jeremy with joy. Today we are trusting God for his growth in faith. Will you pray for him, draw him by your example into the community of faith, and walk with him in the way of Christ? In baptism, Jeremy begins his journey in faith. You speak for him today. Will you care for him and help him to take his place within the life and worship of Christ's church? In baptism, God calls us out of darkness into his marvelous light. To follow Christ means dying to sin and rising to new life with him. Therefore, I ask, do you reject the devil and all rebellion against God?
I reject.
Do you renounce the deceit and corruption of evil?
I renounce.
Do you repent of the sins that separate us from God and neighbor?
I repent of them.
Do you turn to Christ as Savior?
I turn to Christ.
Do you submit to Christ as Lord? Do you come to Christ, the way, the truth, and the life?
I come to Christ.
Christ claims you for his own. Receive the sign of the cross. And parents, godparents, would you make the sign of the cross on his forehead? Do you want to step forward? So just with your finger, make the sign of the cross. Ever so well. Do not be ashamed to confess the faith of Christ crucified. Fight valiantly as a disciple of Christ against sin, the world, and the devil, and remain faithful to Christ to the end of your life. And may Almighty God deliver you from the powers of darkness, restore in you the image of his glory, and lead you in the light and obedience of Christ. Amen. Praise God who made heaven and earth. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water to sustain, refresh, and cleanse all life. Over water, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through water, you led the children of Israel from slavery in Egypt to freedom in the promised land. In water, your son Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us from the death of sin to newness of life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it, we are buried with Christ in his death. By it, we share in his resurrection. Through it, we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we baptize into his fellowship those who come to him in faith. Now sanctify this water, that by the power of your Holy Spirit, Jeremy may be cleansed from sin and born again. Renewed in your image, may he walk by the light of faith and continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, I ask you to stand and profess together with Jeremy the faith of the church. Do you believe and trust in God the Father?
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe and trust in his Son, Jesus Christ?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe and trust in the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen.
Okay, fellow. Oh, such a little one. Do you want to see? Do you want to see? Jeremy Ronan, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May God, who has received you by baptism into his church, pour upon you the riches of his grace, that within the company of Christ's pilgrim people, you may daily be renewed by his anointing spirit, and come to the inheritance of the saints in glory. Amen. Wow, I think this is the most perfect baby in the world. Obviously had a good breakfast. Should we welcome Jeremy? Well done. Parents and godparents, would you take your seats and we come to our prayers?
Let us pray for the whole Church of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs.
Sovereign Lord, your Son has revealed you as our Heavenly Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We were all created for you and by you, and we are your children. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You have made your church a spiritual family, a household of faith. Through baptism, we are reborn as the brothers and sisters of Christ. Deepen our unity and fellowship in him. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You sent your Son to give his life as a ransom for the whole human family. Give justice, peace, and racial harmony to the world he died to save. You are the Almighty, above all dominions and all rulers. And we ask that you imbue all who govern with your wisdom. We bring before you all families torn apart by war, and we pray for an end to hatred and division. Give strength to all who work tirelessly for peace and reconciliation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You gave your Son a share in the life of a family in Nazareth. Help us to value our families, to be thankful for them, and to live sensitively within them. Heal us where there is pain, and bring understanding where there is discord. We give you thanks for baby Jeremy today, and we bring him and his whole family, Jack, Evie, and Toby, before you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Your Son drew around him a company of friends. Bring love and joy to all who are alone, and help us all to find in the brothers and sisters of Christ a loving family. We pray for all those in our St. Margaret's family who need extra love and comfort at this time. Ethan Major, Julia Rees, Jean Bonnet, Mari Evans, Ian Yearsley, Storm, Kasha, Nick, Coralie, Reg Norman, Alison Blower, and Liz Ballinger. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You are the God of the dead as well as of the living. In confidence, we remember those of the household of faith who have gone before us. June Wakefield, Joe Northam, Rafael Martinez, Catherine Lambert, George Earle, Claire Fennell, and on the anniversary of her death 4 years ago, Elizabeth Worth. Bring us with them to the joy of your home in heaven. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Would you please stand? There is one Lord, one faith, one baptism. Jeremy, by one Spirit, we are all incorporated in one body, the Church. We welcome you into the fellowship of the faith. We are children of the same Heavenly Father. We welcome you. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us share with one another a sign of peace.
Peace with you. 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 Peace be with you. Peace be with you, little Jeremy. Peace with you, then. Peace with you.
Thank you.
God of all goodness and grace, receive the gifts we offer and grant that our whole life may give you glory and praise through Jesus Christ. Amen. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Savior. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh as your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin. He lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends. And taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again, he praised you, gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence, his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory.
Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ is alive.
Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favor on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Margaret, and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, O loving Father, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. 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 Blood 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 of Christ, keep you in eternal life. Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts, by faith, with thanksgiving. By your gift, the tree of life was set at the heart of the earthly paradise and the bread of life at the heart of your church. May we who have been nourished at your table on earth be transformed by the glory of the Saviour's cross and enjoy the delights of eternity through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Just a couple of short notices this morning. This afternoon we have a wonderful concert to look forward to. And I have to say it's wonderful because Jack, please stand up, Jack. Jack is a wonderful bass section leader. He's sung everywhere and done lots of opera and is a remarkable singer. But tonight he is going to be singing more things along the jazz lines, which is a little side project of his. Ooh, jazz, musical theatre. Yeah, lots of wonderful things to look forward to. But come, please, and support Jack this afternoon at 4 o'clock, so it won't be dark, it'll be very jolly. Sorry?
Children welcome.
Oh, children are welcome, of course, as well. Yes, 4 o'clock, much easier time, hopefully, so do come along then. Please also take a pew sheet home. There's lots of details of things in Lent. We're going to have some very different Sunday evening services, which will have a more contemplative feel and will engage all the senses, a different style of worship. And then we also have our Lent talks, which are at Putney Methodist Church on Thursday evenings. All the churches in Putney and Roehampton organise them together this year on the theme of pilgrimage, but really good to bring Christians across Putney together. And we'll have a Bible study also on Wednesday mornings before our midweek service. So lots of ways to engage in that Lenten journey. Now, as you heard, it is the anniversary of Elizabeth Worth's death this week. We have a request to help support her legacy. Yeah. Keeps jumping up. There's a catchphrase when Jonathan walks into the offices, and just one more thing.
It is just one more thing. We've done such a wonderful job with the upper hall and all of the parish centre, but now we want to tackle the lower hall. Next weekend, we want to paint the lower hall. We've got wonderful donations of paint and help from two decorators, merchants in Putney, Brewers and Leylands. But we also need, please, volunteers. So if you're up for a little bit of painting, it'll just look wonderful when we've done. Please come along next Saturday at 10 o'clock and help. We'd be really grateful. There will be coffee and donuts. Thanks.
Hopefully some iced donuts this time. Many hands make light works. Children, would you like to come forward? You can show us what you've been doing in Sunday school this week. Do you want to just sort of filter around here, face the people? Adversus populum. Wonderful. Okay, who's going to tell me what have you been up to today? You can start.
We've been drawing some things that we've...
Quick consultation of notes. You've been drawing some things that looks like a little person. Who's that?
That's me.
That's you, and who's that?
My mummy.
That's you and your mummy. So are you going to help? To help as well?
So we've drawn a picture of who we think is wise and written about why they are wise.
Oh, great. So who do you think is wise?
My teacher.
Your teacher. What's your teacher's name?
Miss Lake.
Miss Leg, great. And why is she wise?
Because she makes fair decisions and...
Yeah, that seems very reasonable. Who did you think was wise, Chloe?
A book character.
Oh, who's that?
Lottie Brooks.
Don't know children's fiction anymore. Who's that? What book's she from?
Lottie Brooks.
Okay, fine. Told you I don't know children's literature well enough. And who did you draw?
Albert Einstein.
That's a very good drawing of Albert Einstein. Very nice. He is certainly qualifies for wise. And yourself? And why were we talking about wise people, just out of interest? Is there a reason?
Learning
about wisdom, yeah. And actually, wisdom was in, we didn't have the Old Testament reading today because we had a baptism, but that was all about wisdom and how wisdom is there at the beginning of creation. And wisdom, in a way, is kind of one of the persons of God, but that's a story for another day. Wonderful. Do you want to hold up your posters and we'll give you a big round of applause? Well done. And would you please stand for our final hymn?
As it's seek ye first the kingdom of God, we're going to have a little bit of a group A and group B competition. So remember, this can be sung with the seek ye first going on and the alleluias. So we're all going to sing seek ye first, then we're all going to sing alleluia, and then this team here, I'm looking at you, your team won. Congratulations, what team are you? Give me a hurrah!
Let us pray for God's blessing. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Amen.
God has delivered us from the dominion of darkness and has given us a place with the saints in light. You have received the light of Christ. Walk in this light all the days of your life.
Shine as the light in the world, to the glory of God the Father.
This book contains the stories of God's people. Read it, for it tells how you and your family share in the eternal life and may follow in the way of Jesus Christ. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
and say congratulations to this baby who's been christened.
Right, that's So our kitchen's a bit inadequate. I would have designed them.
You've got some really lovely.